Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're in Computex 2023 in the Republic of Gamers booth, also known as ROG, and today with us, we have you to talk about a little bit about motherboards. Hey, you. How's it going?
Nice to meet you.
Nice
Alejandro,
to meet you, too.
Thank you for inviting me.
No, thank you for having us. So what do we have here? What are we looking at?
Okay, today we're going to be starting with our ROG Maxima series. And this is going to be represented by our Extreme and Hero with this elegant and premium look. And following, we're going to be looking at our ROG Strix series that we like to so-called the front runners at the computing fashion, that's so-called. And okay. It's going to be our whiteboard and the Mini-ITX.
Wow, I can't wait to get to this one, but let's talk about that one. So this is like your Halo product, the one that everybody's aspiring. And then you have, you know, like for all of us, your Strix, and then you have the Maximus Hero. All right, so let's start with the Maximus Stream.
Oh yeah, sure. It's 24 plus one power stages. And since the beginning, we have witnessed how powerful the next gen CPU that Intel gets. So that's why from the ground up, we have been start thinking from the thermal design. So we have taken every single cutting edge into consideration as well as component layout. So we actually make sure that all the components are perfectly matched with every single cutting edge of the heatsink, as well as we're in the PC DIY industry. So we couldn't take out the components into account, right?
Right.
So that's why we also ensure that it gets maximum compatibility with the industrial coolers or GPUs in this case as well.
No, this is great. I love that what you guys have done. You have like all your voltage regulators are completely covered by heatsink, trying to help that performance. And also, I love the LCD screen that you have and the heatsink of, I will say that's the M.2, right?
Yeah, that's the PCIe Gen5 M.2.
I also see that you guys, I think this is what, you have reinforced the PCIe slot.
And yes, we have reinforced it. And best of all, we also include the quick release over here as well for easy installation.
So you guys were the pioneers for the quick release, right?
Oh yeah, we were the first that starts with M.2 Q Lodge for easy installation and also the quick release. And to make it simple, easy, and it also secure.
Yeah, so all the people with big hands and fat fingers like me,
oh, yeah.
Thank you so much.
This guy has suffered.
One, yeah. It makes a lot easier instead of trying to squeeze your finger there and try to release that latch. This is, yes, thank you so much.
No problem.
All right, so let's talk about the Hero.
Yes, with the Hero, talking about thermal, we have also added a backplate to this model as well. And it's not just a backplate that looks cool, but as well as surface purpose. So it's actually covered by thermal pads on the back as well as at the front to cool down the VRM area.
That's pretty neat because I thought first it was, like you said, for looks, then I thought it was for sturdiness as things get heavier. But then when I was talking to you earlier, you told me like, oh, it also works as a thermal heatsink, as a heatsink. I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, I know ROG is known for its looks, but everything that we put into this motherboard is also has served its functional purpose. Because after all, this is a performance-driven community, and we want to get the best performance for the people.
No, this is great. That's something new that I learned today. Thank you. That was great. Yeah, tell me about the Strix.
Yes, the Strix over here is our whiteboard, the Dash A. And it's also, we have rethought about the VRM heatsink area as well. So now it's fully covered, as you can see. I mean, the size is almost the same, right?
Right.
Yes. And as well as we are thinking about the cutting edges, so this board is going to be compatible with most of the coolers that you can see on the market.
Nice. So, yeah, and also you have it in white, you know, because white is the new black, and people are doing tons of builds on that. And also, again, the quick release, which I love a lot. So, all right. So now, this is, when I got to the booth, when I started talking to you, I just went strictly direct to this because it caught my eye because this is a Mini-ITX. So tell me a little bit more about this one.
Sure. So this is our little small form factor build. So if you're a big fan, we actually have putting a lot of thought into this little guy. So starting with the thermal design, we also include two active cooling fans into this VRM area. So that not only cools down the fan, but also transfer the cool air from outside the chassis to directly to the chipsets and the M.2s. We actually have put into new faucet to this. So you see the top layer,
yep.
That usually is the M.2 heatsinks.
Right.
This is actually the backplate of that Gen5 device. So the main heatsink is actually underneath. So it's actually a reverse installation way. That way we can make sure the signal transfer is at its best with the best thermal performance as possible.
Wow, that's great. So pretty much instead of putting the M.2 this way, you flipped it and then you put the heatsink on this side. And then also that helps the signal integrity and have a better performance.
Yes, of course. And we also thought about the user-friendly design as well. So, you know, it will be a lot easier for signal transfer if it goes to the button.
Right.
But that's not convenient. So even though it's just one screw more, we want to keep you away from the trouble. So that's why we go for the engineering and study it and try to put it on the top side.
Wow. Like everything of this Mini-ITX just completely draw me to it. This is such a reduced space, right? It's small.
Mm-hmm.
So you have less real estate to do all the traces and the routes and everything. So like how many layers will this motherboard have compared to a regular motherboard?
Yeah, this is actually 10 layers. So usually on ATX, the most common thing are 6 layers. And in this case, this is actually 10. And since you mentioned about the routings, we also add in 2 accessory cards to this motherboard. One is the newly introduced Strix Hive that brings the old audio solution away from the, you know, the signal and the noise from the motherboard to have a better audio experience, as well as, you know, USB Gen 2 availability, as well as we bring our AIOC button to a physical button. So outside of the box, you can enable it, and it's gonna run the full speed from, and you're gonna experience the fastest and newest from Intel.
Wow, this is great. Thank you so much. I love what you guys have here. I love all the different types of options that you get. And this guy, I can't wait to play with this guy. It looks like a lot of fun. Thank you so much. So we're still here at the ROG booth, and now we're gonna take a closer look at the laptops that they have here. I'm very excited. And with me, we have Sasha. Hi, Sasha.
Hey,
how's it going?
Nice to meet you, Alex.
Nice to meet you. All right, so tell us, we have here 2 very beautiful systems. Tell us what, let's start with the SCAR 18.
Yeah, so those are our flagship gaming laptops. They're the most powerful ones that we have right now in our lineup. We launched them at CS. 18-inch, 16x10 panel, and here we have 16-inch, 16x10. Configuration-wise, you can actually get them at the same spec. So they both come with up to 3980HX at up to 175 watts just for the CPU.
705 watts.
Yes, and an RTX 4090 or 4080, and you can get low versions as well. We got liquid metal conductor node extreme on both the CPU and the GPU. So that's a custom liquid metal formula we created together with Thermal Grizzlies, pure indium gallium, even lower temperatures than a normal liquid metal. And yeah, we have an edge-to-edge heatsink. So this is all heatsink. And turn it around.
Yeah, turn it around.
You can see it.
So there. From side all the way side to side is all heatsink, and also on the side. So that plus the liquid metal is what allows you to heat those like 175 watts.
Right.
Wow, that is impressive.
And we added a third fan as well. So it's like super cool and super quiet despite all of the super high wattage. So yeah, that's what really sets the SCAR laptops apart from our slimmer and more portable Zephyrus laptops is you always get super cool surface temperatures even after hours of gaming, and they're much quieter as well. So you got much more thermal space.
No, this is great. Tell us a little bit about the screen refresh rates.
Yep. So for the 18-inch, we're looking at a Nebula panel. Nebula is like our standard, so you get all the good stuff. You get G-Sync, you get 500 nits, 100% DCI-P3, and this one is a 240 hertz QHD.
Wow.
And for 16-inch, we even have our Nebula HDR panel, which is like another step up. This one is a mini LED screen with 1,024 zones. That's more than most TVs have, and you have it on the 16-inch screen, so it looks amazing.
So that is amazing for the performance of that. So this will be, with that type of resolution, I mean, both of them are great for content creators, but I guess this one will have a better, when it comes to high fidelity of pictures, resolution, and different things.
And a very important feature as well is high brightness. So with the mini LED, you can go up to 1100 nits in HDR mode, and then 600 nits in SDR mode. And very important for creators is we have a function in Armory Crate that you can turn off the individual zones.
Oh wow.
So you can switch it to single zone mode, because that's really important as a creator. Otherwise, if you just paint like a few pixels, then the backlight changes and then the color actually looks slightly different. Yeah, so
it throws you off a little. So for that content creator, like also RAM and storage is very important. So what do you guys have here?
2 Gen 4 M.2 SSD slots. You can upgrade them as well. As far as I know, you can actually even put up to 8 terabyte SSDs in there. So 16 terabyte maximum in theory, you can upgrade it to. And memory, 64 gigabytes, DDR5.
Well, these are beautiful systems. What about the ports? So I guess let's grab this one and do a little bit close up on the ports that you guys have in there.
So we have 2 Type-C boards, obviously Thunderbolt. You can Type-C charge them as well.
Oh,
so
wow.
if you're not running them at full performance, you can just take your phone charger or any Type-C charger and you can charge the laptop and you basically never run out of battery. Like if you're just browsing the web, we got a 2.5G LAN port, mm-hmm. it's really high speed as well. We got the DC barrel jack if you want full performance for gaming. We got heatsink. And heatsink and two Type-A ports.
Nice. No, these are beautiful laptops, and I mean they look pretty sturdy. I like the finish, the color scheme that you have, and also the keyboard.
Oh, an HDMI. Sorry, I skipped
the
HDMI.
Yeah, the HDMI.
It's HDMI 2.1, mm-hmm. the real 2.1.
Yeah.
Not the 2.0 that was renamed. So yeah.
Well, Sasha, thank you so much. These are great, but I also heard that you have some other laptops that you want us to show.
Yeah. Let's look at the other stuff, the Asus stuff.
Awesome. Thank you. Okay, so now we have come from the ROG booth to the Asus booth, and we're gonna check out these Asus laptops. They look really, really nice. So, Sasha,
hey.
Tell us a little bit more.
So, we got our flagship model here, our Zenbook S13 OLED. This is a flagship model for us here at the Asus booth at Computex this year. What's cool about it is it's an ultra-light, ultra-thin laptop. So it's 1 centimeter thin, 1 kilo light. It's an OLED screen. It has really long battery life despite being so slim and light. Usually you get compromises for ultrabooks when they get super light, super thin, but this one, not really. So we still have full I/O, we got an HDMI port, 2 Thunderbolt ports, and we got a microphone jack and full-size Type A as well. Huge touchpad, nice webcam, 1080p webcam, separate IR camera. My favorite part about it though is the lid. It's our plasma ceramic aluminum. So essentially what this is we submerge it into a special bath with some catalysts inside, and we run really high voltage through it, and it creates small bubbles of plasma on the surface of the aluminum, which creates aluminum oxide, which mm-hmm. usually is a bad thing. Yeah. But because of the plasma, there's so much energy, the atoms and the electrons, like it's all just whizzing around. Once it settles down, it settles into a lattice crystal structure of aluminum, oxygen, and it becomes super tough. So this is harder than regular aluminum, even though it's aluminum oxide. So usually rust is like weaker, but this actually makes it stronger. And it's much better for the environment because there's no dyes, no chemicals, nothing. This is pure aluminum oxide, but in a very special chemical structure that makes it super strong.
No, that's beautiful. And that's the actual color, and that's why you need anything else to do it. And you're saying that this goes up to like Core i7?
Yes, it goes up to a Core i7, up to 20 watt of TDP in this super thin and light laptop. It's crazy, right?
And this is like your Evo laptop.
Yeah, and 60 watt hour battery in this.
60 hour watt?
There's a 60 watt hour battery in this.
This is beautiful. And the screen, the OLED screen, it's so crispy.
2.8K OLED, our Asus Lumina OLED screen. Yeah.
And like you said, 1 centimeter, and you're able to fit on so many ports.
Yeah.
It's very impressive. Okay, this is pretty cool. So let's go to the next one.
For the next one here, interesting, maybe let's do the B9 first.
Okay, let's do the B9
ExpertBook. This one is 14 inch, but it's actually lighter. It's only 990 grams. That's because it's made from lithium magnesium.
Lithium magnesium. It's a lot lighter. Like you said, it's a bigger screen,
yes.
and lighter
yes.
compared to, this was 1 kilogram.
Right, this is 1 kilo and this is 990 grams. This is a little bit more than 1 kilo. This is 990. 14 inch, mm-hmm. Also 16 by 10, 2.8K OLED. 2 fans, which is really unusual for such a compact laptop. Really good performance, 20 watts as well, TDP, Core i7. Really, really nice.
Really nice.
Premium laptop.
And you were telling me this earlier about the sustainability story on this one.
Yes, so this is our first carbon neutral commercial laptop, and this is our first carbon neutral consumer laptop. So what we do is essentially we hired another company to do research on beginning to end to create this laptop. How much carbon do we produce? Even our suppliers, like mining the minerals, everything. And then we pay a carbon trading company to offset that. So when you buy this laptop, there's like no impact on the environment at all.
Wow, no, that's great. You know, gotta be conscious about our surroundings.
Yeah, and last but not least, we have our Vivobook S, 15 inch, also with an OLED screen. Very nice blue color, really love that. This is our special color accent. We have that on all our Vivobooks. It's kind of like a fashion thing.
No, I like the accent a lot. Actually, this was the first one that caught my eye just because like what you said, the color accent and the button. I was like, oh, that's really nice. I mean, it kind of moves away a little bit from the grays and the blacks,
yes.
which is really nice.
Yeah, yeah. This one has a 120 hertz 2.8K OLED display, Asus Lumina OLED display. So 120 hertz. And this one also comes with an Intel Arc A350M option.
Oh, nice. The 350M, our mobile graphics in there?
Yeah. And it has, you know, even more I/O ports, obviously. So you got a Type-A port here, Yeah. You got a full-size HDMI, another Type-A, and a Thunderbolt port, audio jack.
All these systems are just so beautiful, so well done, sturdy.
All metal chassis, yeah.
Yeah, and they're so light and so thin. Like, great for traveling. Well, I mean, great for everybody, but especially now that I'm traveling here in Computex, like, oh, this would have been a lot lighter than what I currently have.
Yeah, depending on what screen size you need, you know, we got something super light, all metal chassis just for you, and sustainable.
Yes. Well, Sasha, thank you so much. Learned a lot today. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
So there was one more thing that we want to show you guys here at the Asus booth. We found a W790-SAGE motherboard. This is for Sapphire Rapids, and we're very excited to see it and to show it to you guys because this is kind of brand new. So again, we have Sasha here to help us out. Hey, Sasha.
Hey. So yeah, really cool about this motherboard. Let me pick it up here. You got 7 Gen 5 slots, and you have 2 extra Gen 5 SSD slots. There are 4 lanes. There's another Gen 4 slot here with 4 lanes. So you got tons of PCI Express lanes. You have 8 memory channels and 1 DIMM per channel. So that's each DIMM is its own channel. 16 phases for the VRM, and they're all digital.
Wow.
And this heatsink here is not for the VRM. This is for the Ethernet ports, because there's not one, there's 2 10G Ethernet port plus an extra management port. And we have our own separate chip on here that allows you to do all the remote network management configuration, has graphics as well, so you can see something even if you have no graphics card plugged in. So yeah, crazy all the way over the top. And it's a workstation board, but you can overclock it. That is really unusual. Right, and we have a really cool system built with it here as well from APAC. And it makes use of the second power supply that you can plug in. So you can run 2 in here. And this is a dual 4090 overclocked with 2 1600 watt power supplies. Absolutely crazy. So there's nothing holding you back. Everything water cooled. Can really go crazy with this motherboard.
Now, this is insane. So what you have there, I think what you told me earlier, that you have a W3400,
W3400,
the overclockable version of the Sapphire Rapids, which is in there, which is pretty awesome. The other thing that we were talking before is the way that this memory channels are positioned is because you want the airflow to go this way. So that way you're also going to be cooling instead of the other ones I've seen in the regular motherboards are there.
They kind of block the airflow.
They block the airflow, but here's to optimize the airflow to improve that.
And we have the back cover as well.
Yeah, the back cover.
We got a really cool, super heavy back cover. So this board does not flex at all. It's like crazy rigid.
Yeah, cannot. Structural purposes, right?
Yeah, because you know you have a lot of pressure on here for the heatsink or the water cooler that you use. You have all the stuff pulling on it, memory. So this really keeps it all straight and in place. Really, really crazy system.
It's really nice. Well, Sasha, thank you so much for giving a tour.
Sure.
And I appreciate it.
Welcome.
Thank you.